What's up guys, Luke here. Today we have another reaction video with Mecha Top 10's Acrocanthosaurus versus Spinosaurus. Yeah, Spinosaurus wins. I just know it. It's just more bigger, stronger, more powerful. So yeah, well, let's move on with the video. And also, by the way, sorry if my volume is not so good, if you cannot hear Mega Top 10 talking. Like, actually, I don't have a good working headphone. I had one, but yeah, these destroyed. I'll make another video about what happened with the thing. Well, sorry, I actually hear with one part the noise, but with the other part not. And I still need to wait for a new headphone. Until that, you need to just deal with the volume. So, well, let's move on with the video. Rolls off the tongue nicely. Acrocanthosaurus is the battle of the sail-backed dinosaurs. Acrocanthosaurus, meaning high-spined lizard, was among the largest known theropods to exist. The largest known specimen, NCSM14345, is estimated to have measured 11.5 meters from snout to tail tip, weighed 5 to 7 metric tons. The skull alone was nearly 1.3 meters in length. Spinosaurus, well, needs no introduction, lived in what is now Egypt during the Cretaceous period, around 100 million years ago. Did he walk on 2 feet or four? Who knows? It's vital.
Yeah, Spinosaurus walks on 2 feet. It could be that he walks on 4 feet and 2 feet. I guess he walks first on 2 feet to just walk, but I think that he uses 4 feet to kind of sit by the water, so grabbing fish. I guess that is more accurate than a Spinosaurus that only walks on 4 feet. Like, that's also not good. Like, dinosaurs like the Carcharodontosaurus and the Sarcosuchus can then go easily bite the neck and crush it off the Spinosaurus. If the Spinosaurus only walks on its 2 feet, then yes, Carcharodontosaurus and the Sarcosuchus are kind of fucked. But it's more believable that Spinosaurus walks on both. Yeah, that's more believable. Yeah, I mean on 2 feet and for 4 feet. Let me know in the comments, do you think that is more accurate or not?
Okay, first some stats. Spinosaurus, height, 4 meters at hips, maybe 6 meters at head, length, 16 meters, weight, 9 to 12 tons average.
That's a terrifying looking Spinosaurus. You can see that in a kind of a horror movie, like look at the eyes, jeez. But let's move on with the video.
Could be up to 20 metric tons. Yeah, Spino fans would love that. Bite force, 2 to 3 tons. Speed, 25 kilometers per hour. Diet, fish and small dinosaurs. Now to the weapons of Spinosaurus.
Well, Spinosaurus also hunted dinosaurs like the duck-billed Uranosaurus. That is not actually a small dinosaur, that's like way the fuck big. Uranosaurus is just smaller than the Spinosaurus, but in the drought season, Spinosaurus hunted Uranosaurus. So, Spinosaurus did not only eat small creatures and fish, also big creatures. Well, I like a feathered T-Rex more than the scaly one. Let me know in the comments, do you like a scaly T-Rex or a feathered one? And sorry if I'm pausing so much. Sorry for that. But yeah, I need to talk in my videos.
Most notable feature of Acrocanthosaurus was its row of tall neural spines.
Actually, an interesting fact about the Acrocanthosaurus is actually a Carcharodontosaurid. And in the family is the Carcharodontosaurus, Acrocanthosaurus, I think the Zayats, and Saurophaganax, and the Allosaurus. So, Allosaurids are actually Carcharodontosaurids. So, yeah.
Spinosaurus possessed larger hand claws, 5 centimeters longer than Acros. Spinosaurus was the better swimmer. Now onto the disadvantage.
That's true. Spinosaurus was a better swimmer.
Spinosaurus may have been larger, but he was probably shorter in height. Acro could slash an attack above. Spinosaurus was likely slower and less agile than Acro.
If I said earlier, like, Spinosaurus is not shorter in height, well, maybe he is. It's kind of difficult, like, walks the Spinosaurus on 4 legs or 2? I still kind of believe on both, like 2 and 4.
Taurus possessed a large sail that could intimidate, but it was also vulnerable to attack. The sail was fused with the spine. If it got slammed by Acro, the result would be devastating. Spinosaurus may have possessed weaker height. Now onto the advantages of Acrocanthosaurus. Well, he was smaller, but perhaps he was much more agile on land. His jaws were more adapted to killing large animals, and he was no stranger to bringing down massive sauropods. Now to the disadvantages of Acrocanthosaurus. Acrocanthosaurus was smaller and lighter. He possessed smaller hand claws. He wasn't a good swimmer. Well, not as good as Spinosaurus, anyway. Okay, let's fight. Spinosaurus and Acrocanthosaurus meet at a clearing. The ground is wet and swampy. Spinosaurus is usually quite a passive dinosaur, but this Acrocanthosaurus is a threat to its fish supply, so he must act. He charges at Acro, hoping to scare him away. Acro charges back. He's not afraid of large dinosaurs. Spino slashes Acro, but misses. Acro slashes back and bites Spino on the neck. Spinosaurus claws Acro and breaks free. It's a deep wound. The agile Acro runs behind Spino and bites him on the leg. Spinosaurus flees into the river like a cow. Acrocanthosaurus approaches the shore, wondering where Spino went to. Suddenly, Spino leaps out of the water, drags Acro into the depths of the river, never to be seen again. Verdict: Acrocanthosaurus is a massive dinosaur. A Spinosaurus is even more massive. Acro may be used to hunting large sauropods, but hey, they don't possess 20-centimeter hand claws. Unless it's Iguanodon.
Well, Acrocanthosaurus is more used to hunting, I think. Yeah, this is the end of this video. Yeah, I want to say which dinosaur Acrocanthosaurus hunted, but because of this thing, I cannot go through. But leave a like, subscribe, and leave a comment, so later.